shooting scenes with Roy Cropper and Tony Gordon where Tony throws Roy into the canal. Well, you've got a lot of things to take into consideration. There's the health and safety element of it. So we've had to test the water for bacteria levels. We've also had to have divers sweep the bottom of the canal to make sure there's nothing dangerous and harmful there when the body doubles and the actors go in there. The water for the canal had to be tested about 3 or 4 weeks in advance. So obviously if there'd have been a problem with that, then we would have had to have looked for a new location, but thankfully the levels have come up all right.
I've not been sleeping so well recently. Bad dreams. Because of you. My conscience has been bothering me. So I thought it was time to do something about it.
By way of being prepared for going in the water, we've had to make sure that they've had tetanus jabs, they've had to have breathing tests. Obviously, we have to make sure that they can swim or they've not got a fear of water.
The stunt tonight, I'm not sure how much I'm doing of it. I mean, we've got stuntmen who are doing some of it. I've got to go in the canal, and I'm not particularly looking forward to that. Everyone in Coronation Street at some point or other is going to end up in the canal. We had the Platts. Don Brennan, I think, drove Alma into the canal. And this is my opportunity to taste... I think it's the Bridgewater Canal in Manchester, but we'll call it the Weatherfield Canal.
When we're filming scenes like this and we're using body doubles, obviously we'd like to use the cast as much as possible. It just depends how it goes, really. Obviously all the close-up stuff on the faces will be done by the real actors. You sometimes don't know until you actually start rehearsing it and blocking it through how much the actors can actually do. But it's hoped that, you know, most of the stuff will be done by the actors.
I can't swim.
Good.
We'll do as much as we can in the actual canal here, and that'll be all the stuff where we see them on the surface and struggling and fighting, but the actual underwater stuff we're not going to shoot here. We'll shoot that in an underwater tank, and that's it's used by the military, but it's also used by a lot of film crews. At least in the underwater tank, it's a bit more of a controlled environment and it's warmer, so we can keep the actors under there for a bit longer. And there's, you know, specially trained divers there as well to help them with the breathing. So it just means we're in a more controlled environment. It's been a lot of hard work to achieve what we've done, but yeah, I think we're all very, very happy.